Hello everyone, this is Ivy Brown back with the explanation of Chapter 1, Tansen the Magical Musician. If you have not watched Part 1, please do watch Part 1 so that you can follow Part 2 as well. The link of Part 1 is given in the description box, so you can go through it and please do watch Part 1 before watching Part 2. So let's start with the next page, that's page number 15. One evening, Emperor Akbar decided to visit Tansen. When the emperor arrived, Tansen was singing and playing the Tanpura. The emperor sat quietly in the veranda and listened to him. So pleased was the emperor with Tansen's music that after the performance, he took off his diamond necklace and presented it to Tansen. Now here we see that one evening, the emperor, which emperor? Emperor Akbar, he decided to go and visit Tansen. When the emperor arrived, Tansen was singing and he was playing the Tanpura. The emperor sat quietly. Instead of disturbing Tansen, he sat quietly in the veranda. Now, veranda is just like a gallery or balcony, you can say, right? So, he sat there quietly and he listened to him. He was so pleased with Tansen's music that after his performance, the king, the emperor Akbar, he took off his diamond necklace and he presented it to Tansen. Some courtiers became very jealous of the emperor's high regard for Tansen. They stole the diamond necklace given by the emperor and told him that Tansen had sold it for a large sum of money. When summoned to the royal court and asked to produce the necklace, Tansen was unable to do so. The emperor flew into a rage. "You will be banished from the court till you can present yourself wearing the necklace," roared the emperor. Now what happened, you know, some courtiers, as you all know, what is the meaning of courtiers? People who are a part of the king's or queen's court, okay? So the courtiers were very jealous seeing that, you know, Emperor Akbar is giving so much emphasis and so much, you know, regards he's having for Tansen. This made the courtiers very jealous. You know, people are very jealous if they see somebody doing well, right? So now similarly, these courtiers also became very jealous. How come he is getting so much recognition? How come he is getting so much regards from the emperor? So what they did, they wanted, now they were jealous. So they wanted to trouble Tansen. So what they did is, they stole is robbed, okay? So they robbed the diamond necklace given by the emperor to Tansen, and they told the emperor that Tansen had sold it for a large sum of money. Now when summoned means ordered to appear. When the emperor ordered Tansen to appear to the royal court and asked him to show the necklace, so Tansen was unable to do so because he did not have it, because we know that it was robbed by the courtiers. The emperor flew into a rage. Rage means anger, you know, terrible anger. So now he became very, very angry because he actually thought that the courtiers were speaking the truth and that Tansen had sold the necklace. So now when he came into that rage, that anger, "You will be banished." Now what means banished? Banished means order somebody to leave the place. He said, "You will be banished. You will be thrown out of this place, thrown out of the court till you can present. You can only enter the court now when you present yourself wearing the necklace." And he was really very angry. So now Tansen was in disgrace. Now, how bad Tansen was feeling. Here, Tansen was in disgrace. It means that he had lost his respect, disgrace. He was disgraced. He lost his respect. He had no one to turn to. He didn't know where to go, whom to ask for help, what to do. At last, he thought of King Ramachandra and set off for Rewa. Ramachandra welcomed his former court musician After hearing the whole story, the king said, "Don't worry, just sing for me." Now, he was earlier working for King Ramachandra. Okay, so he was the king of Reba, right? So at last he thought, now where am I going to go? So he went to King Ramachandra. He set off for Reba. Ramachandra welcomed his former court musician. He was the musician of his court, right? So he welcomed him. And after hearing the whole story, when Tansen narrated the whole story to King Ramachandra, the king said, "You don't worry, Tansen, you just sing for me." So that was so sweet of King Ramachandra, because he believed Tansen. Tansen sang two beautiful ragas for the king. "You have brought me great joy," said Ramachandra. And as a token of appreciation, he presented his jeweled sandals to Tansen. Now just see this. Now when Tansen sang two beautiful ragas for the king, you know, he felt so happy. He was full with joy. He got so happy that as a token of appreciation, he presented his jeweled sandals, means his sandals which were, you know, full of jewels, precious jewels. He gave it to Tansen. Tansen rushed back to Agra and placed the jeweled sandals in front of the emperor. What Tansen did is, he immediately took that jeweled sandal and he, you know, rushed back to Agra. Agra is the place where Emperor Akbar was staying, and he was ruling India, so he was there. So now what happened is, he placed those precious sandals in front of the emperor. "So please take the diamonds from these and forgive me." Now he apologized. He said, "You take the diamonds from this sandals and you just forgive me." The jeweled sandals were worth much more than the necklace. The necklace was not that precious. How much those jeweled sandals were? The emperor immediately realized that he had misjudged Tansen. Now he understood that he had made a mistake in understanding Tansen. And he said, "Your music is much more valuable than diamonds to me. I should never have doubted you. Return to my court as my royal musician." Now, when he realized that he made a mistake, when Emperor Akbar realized, so what he did is, he asked him to, you know, come back and join his court as a royal musician. Tansen's fame spread far and wide. Tansen's enemies grew more jealous. Now children, you know what, when people do something very well in life, there are so many people to get jealous of them, because they can't do that good. So what they do is, they just have jealousy, you know, "Oh, how he is doing better than me." This is because of jealousy. Now people became more jealous of Tansen. They suggested to the emperor that he command Tansen to sing Deepak Rag. Now what they did is, the jealous people, they suggested the emperor, they asked the emperor that he should command Tansen to sing Deepak Rag. Now Deepak Rag was one of the most difficult ragas to sing. Besides, so much heat would be caused by a perfect rendering of this rag, that not only would lamps alight, but the singer's body too would burn to ashes. Now this rag was such a rag that if it was, you know, sung properly, rendering means performance of a piece of music. So when, if it was performed, that piece of music was performed that well, what would happen is, lamps would light. And not only the lamps would light, but also the singer's body would burn into ashes. Now what basically the people wanted, they were jealous of him and they wanted him to die. They wanted to kill him. So they knew that he is very good and he can sing the Deepak Rag. But what was their intention was that when he sings the Deepak Rag, he will, you know, burn into ashes and he will die. When Akbar asked Tansen to sing Deepak Rag, Tansen pleaded, "Sir, Deepak Rag can set the singer himself on fire." But the emperor would not listen. Now what happened is, now Akbar asked Tansen to sing the Deepak Rag. Now Tansen pleaded means requested. He said, sir, Deepak Rag can set the singer himself on fire. That means Tansen said that I myself will be set to fire. So he tried to convince the emperor, but the emperor wouldn't listen at all. Tansen knew that singing Deepak Rag was dangerous, but he also knew that if Megh Rag, which brings the rain, could be sung at the same time, he would be saved from the fury of fire. Now, you see, he knew, he was a smart musician. He knew that, okay, fine, Deepak Rag was very dangerous, but if Megh Rag, which brings the rain, could be sung at the same time, he would be saved from the danger. Fury is danger, danger of fire. But how can I sing both rags at the same time? Now, this was very difficult. He didn't know how to sing both the rags at the same time. Either he could sing Deepak Rag or the Megh Rag, but then it had to go together. Okay, so if fire is being lit, at least Megh Rag brings the rain and, you know, the fire subsides. You know, the fire ends, comes to an end. So now he didn't know how to sing both the rags together at the same time. Tansen thought worriedly to himself. Now he became very worried. Okay? As he roamed in his garden, suddenly he remembered Rupa, a devoted disciple of Haridas. Now he remembered about Rupa. And who was Rupa? Rupa was a devoted disciple of Haridas. Haridas is the one who taught Tansen music, isn't it? And Haridas is the one who also taught music to Rupa. With the permission of Haridas, Rupa agreed to sing. Rupa was already a very good musician. Tansen used the 15-day preparation time granted by Akbar to train her. At the end of 2 weeks, Rupa had perfected the singing of Megh Rag. Now, he took the permission of Haridas so that Rupa could sing, and Rupa agreed to sing. Okay, Rupa was a very good musician herself. Tansen, in just 15 days time, he managed to train Rupa. Okay, because he was granted 15 days time by Emperor Akbar. So in that those 15 days time only, he managed to train Rupa. And at the end of 2 weeks, Rupa perfected. She became perfect at singing the Megh Rag. On the day of the performance, the court was packed. That means the day the performance was going to take place, the complete court was crowded. So many people had come to see this. Unlit lamps were placed on the walls. Unlit lamps means the lamps which were not lit. Okay, so they were placed on the walls to just see whether the Deepak Rag, was performed properly and whether the lamps could start lighting. As soon as the emperor entered and sat on the throne, Tansen began the alap. Alap is the part of rag that serves as the beginning. Okay, the beginning of the rag. So he started his alap. As Tansen sang on, the surrounding air got warmer. And as he started singing, the air in the surrounding started to get warmer. The audience started perspiring. Now all those who were there, who had come to see the audience, they started perspiring. Okay? Leaves and flowers in the garden dried and fell to the ground. All the leaves and flowers in the garden suddenly dried up and they fell to the ground. Water in the fountains began to boil. Now just imagine how warm the environment had become, that the water that was there in the fountain, it began to boil. Birds flew away to escape. All the birds flew away to save themselves. The lamps lit up and flames appeared in the air. Not only the lamps lit up, but also you could see the flames in the air. People fled from the court in terror. Now people were so scared that they ran from there. They fled from the court. As the emperor stood up, listening with awe, a rose that he often held in his hand drooped. Now, when he was like full of, praises for Tansen and he stood up, what happened? The rose that he used to hold in his hand, it drooped. Okay, drooped means bent downwards. Now, Tansen's body was hot and feverish. Now, Tansen's body also became hot and feverish, but absorbed in Deepak Rag. But he was so much absorbed into the music of Deepak Rag, he continued to sing vigorously. He just continued to sing with his complete energy. Seeing Tansen in this state, Rupa began singing Megh Rag. As her voice grew stronger and soared, as she started now, she knew what was going on and she began singing the Megh Rag. As her voice grew louder and stronger, the sky became dark with clouds. Soon rain came pouring down. Many among the audience rushed out to be cooled by the rain. Now everybody were feeling so hot that they ran out to be cooled by the rain. Soon everything returned to normal. People showered praises on Tansen's genius. People started showering praises. Oh wow, he's just a genius. Though the emperor was very, very pleased, he was very happy, but he was shocked that he had almost lost his greatest musician to the fire of the singer's own music. But he was shocked that, oh my God, what was I doing? I could lose my, you know, best musician. So now Tansen's fame spread like flames of Deepak Rag. Now Tansen's fame, his respect also started spreading, his name started spreading like the flame of Deepak Rag. Centuries later, Tansen's music has lived on. Now also, when we hear about Tansen, we have a lot of regards for him, because we know that Tansen was a wonderful musician. He was one of the best musicians. So it has been passed on from guru to disciple. And every year in Gwalior, near Tansen's tomb, a music festival is held. Musicians come here from all over India to perform and pay homage to Tansen. So this is how, you know, till date he is being respected, and people go there to Gwalior near Tansen's tomb, and a musical festival is held there. Okay, so this is all about Tansen, the magical musician. This story was abridged by Ashok Davar. So I hope you've got a clear understanding of the chapter. So please do listen to it again and again for better understanding. See you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.